Now, a special treat on this Halloween, a story about the magic of movies and zombies. The NewsHour's Mike Melia has our update.
You don't often get to see someone's dreams come true, even if they are the stuff of nightmares. We first met Sam Suchmann and Mattie Zufelt 2 years ago, when all they had was a big idea and a Kickstarter to make an epic zombie movie.
It's gonna be like between horror and comedy, intensity, drama, fame kind of thing.
We have every average, everyday teen drama, like love triangles, or like heartbreaks, or betrayals, or people living like...
Or it could be like teenager secret life.
What I do to Maddie is I leave him behind, and that is not cool, so...
No, you can't leave Fred behind.
The best friends, both with Down syndrome, first met at the Special Olympics in grade school. From his living room in Rhode Island, Sam told us a very personal reason for wanting to make this movie.
My whole life, I feel like I never fit in anywhere or have a voice. But someday, that will change. I'll be somebody, and that day is today.
In many ways, Sam was right. Their lives were about to change in dramatic ways. Their Kickstarter raised nearly $70,000. They gathered together family, friends, along with film industry and special effects professionals. It was all happening. We got invited on set for a day when they were filming a party scene on a yacht. Sam and Mattie originally wanted a cruise ship, but this was close. Peter Farrelly, behind hits like Dumb and Dumber and Something About Mary, was also on set. I was transformed into a zombie, but more on that later. The day before, the Jersey Shore's DJ Paulie D was there. He had been at the top of Sam and Maddie's wish list for celebrity cameos. In some ways, they were becoming famous.
I want to be famous because I want to be a DJ.
I want to be famous because I love to sing.
Yeah, he's a good
voice. I'm a singer, and I can rap, too. I do a little rap, if you want to hear.
Is that cool? I'd
love
to hear, yeah.
I'm like, yo, I'm rocking that roast, right? Yo, he's like a teenage D, what's up? You can't see me, yo, it's right. I got flow like Jack Swagger. I got Swagger, yo, check it, yeah, what?
Yeah,
sure.
Yeah, it's really good, yeah, dude.
There are no record deals yet, but since our story first aired, Sam and Mattie have been profiled by People Magazine, The Today Show, The Huffington Post, just to name a few. Microsoft flew them to L.A. as the official spokes dudes for the Special Olympics World Games in 2015.
Stay tuned for more.
Yeah.
And they also made the movie. Spring Break Zombie Massacre premiered in September in their hometown of Providence. A week later, they were guests on Conan O'Brien's show.
What I love about what you guys have done is you met years ago, you talked about this dream, and you made it happen. Here we are all these years later, and you made your zombie movie, and you had a premiere that the press attended. Everyone loves the movie, and then you fly out here to come on our show. Yes, this is pretty spectacular.
It is pretty spectacular. I caught up with them for the film's New York City premiere. They pulled up to the red carpet in a bloody SUV to a long line of fans waiting outside. Don't be confused. This is not a kid's movie.
This is a hard R, okay? Like, there's guts. There's urinating on guts, okay?
Jesse Suchmann is Sam's brother. He helped put together the original Kickstarter and has helped orchestrate everything since.
I have learned so much from them, and I want to be like them. And I think that their confidence in their ideas and their clarity of vision and their confidence in themselves is so intoxicating to everyone around them that it drives everybody to do better.
This is Zombie Mike, by the way.
It's been a wild ride for me, too. Remember when I said I became a zombie? Turns out, and here's a mini spoiler, in the climactic fight scene, I get my head split open by a record thrown by DJ Paulie D. After the New York screening, I asked Sam and Mattie what it's been like for them.
It's a hell of a ride. It is. I never expecting much people. I never expecting to get much people to see this movie.
My advice is chase your dreams and always follow your dreams. Don't let anyone tell you different. And don't be a victim to bullies. And in a quote, do not party like me and Mattie. I'm looking forward for having more Sam and Mattie adventures on the way.
Yeah, there is.
Yeah, there is. Mattie DJing, me teaching dance, DJing in. I can't wait. It's going to be fun.
Just yesterday, they were featured on CBS Sunday Morning.
I don't do it for fame. I do it because I love it. You know, because...
I'm doing it for the money.
You're doing it for the money?
Yeah.
Well, I do it because I love it.
Have you gotten rich on this so far?
Not yet.
They are also making a documentary about their journey. Tim Forrester is leading that project.
We see that as being kind of the big culmination of this whole thing. Obviously, the movie stands on its own, and we think that, you know, festivals are going to love it, people are going to love it on its own. But to see the time, the effort, the patience involved with making this movie, that's the real story.
On this Halloween, updating a feel-good zombie story, I'm Mike Melia for the PBS NewsHour.
Sam and Mattie have a big future. We want to be there to cover the whole thing.